Let me just tell you guys, it has become a digital phenomenon. Some people think this is a bad idea. Others think this is the best thing that has happened to the internet. Anyway, yes, let me read some feedback that's coming through, especially on Facebook. We are streaming this live on Facebook. Let me just read some Facebook comments right here. Leonid Angolovale says, men's conference is lit. Abdul Hussein says, Mwanaume akae akiwa mwanaume na akufe akiwa mwanaume. There are two people who have stood out from the panel, Mkala and Mankush. You guys are causing a bit of a stir on Facebook, especially. Evan Manjala says, the way Moi's funeral was aired, full day, we demand the same in men's conference. They want a full day men's conference. That's Evan Manjala says that. Magimu say, this guy sijini man kush, sijui kush ama nani, niko na swali moja na yeye, kwani hawa wanawake hawana kwao. Shame on you. That's why I say, man, kush. It's all the guards are down on Facebook. It is. Ago is agreeing with you, Mankush, and I say, Mankush, wambie, huyo dame, amedai nywele, anadhani anajua kila kitu. That is for you, Anitare. That is Anitare. Ago, Hemson, and I say, unadhani anajua kila kitu. Jesse J says, my sponsor ndio mumeharibia vijana, bad wana hassle. Kitu approach, nyinyi mnasema sasa kijana atakupeleka wapi? Aya, wanasema masponsor basically wanaharibu soko. Nasema Trevor kindly uliza hao wanawake wanakunywa chai ya wanaume. How do they feel when they eat our fare? Nick J says, volume please. This is on our Facebook. Salute Mankush. Mankush, you're taking over Facebook, man. Keep your teach Kericho, men's conference with a woman inside, but why? Asking. Says all of these comments coming through our Facebook. You can stream live on Facebook. We are live on the Citizen TV Kenya Facebook page, on Twitter as well. Let me read some Twitter. There's a bunch of Twitter people who don't think this is a good idea, but let me just briefly. And somebody here says, this is Saki Mugora says, unless the men's conference 2020 is chaired by Mzee Kibor in attendance. I'm not gonna read that one. Anyway, on Twitter you can follow the conversation, hashtag men's conference 2020. You can talk to us, say whatever you want. We are not restricting you. It's a bad idea, it's a good idea. Opinion is split. The women are thinking, okay, you guys were real, we thought this was a joke. Yes, and that is some of the comments coming from our social media. Let me speak to some people. The gentleman over here who had just briefly before we go back to Trevor, this gentleman over here has an opinion about wanaume wamewekwa. Tuambie jina yako, alafu tuambie about what you wanted to tell me about wanaume ambao wamewekwa.
Yeah, my name is Serkal. I want to condemn the men who are married. There is nothing that justifies the fact that mwanaume anafaa kusurvive by kutosheleza mahitaji ya wanawake za kingono kusurvive. There is nothing that justifies. Those men must be condemned from the society. I want to say that the biggest problem that we have right now is the confusions that we are undergoing as a generation. You see, in our culture, we had a way, our cultures, like Amaluo, we had a way that Luos had to be men. But when colonization came, Christianity came, the media came, this animal called globalization has really disorganized our structures as human beings. And therefore, we are undergoing a lot of confusion. And you could see it at the panel. Everybody has their own version about who a man should be. I think we should study the man, should study a woman. And I want to take this opportunity to wish my lovely wife, Lucy. My wife, Lucy, the best Valentine. Yeah, she's the best.
Yani brother umeongea hiyo kizungu yote alafu anaharibu. Okay, let me just take it back to Trevor. You guys mtaongea. Trevor, with the panel a bit, I want you guys to talk about that a bit. Wanaume ambao wanaishi kwa kutosheleza mahitaji Yeah, wanawake. Take it away, Trevor.
You know, when he said married men, he meant wanaume ambao wamewekwa. Not the actual marriage, just if you're married there, he wasn't taking a swipe at you. He meant the ones when you are depending on the women for everything. And that's the other thing that we were talking about earlier on. And while I was coming to you, there's a concern here that men have a pedestal for the wife that they're going to marry, and it's often their mother. You're supposed to cook like my mother, take care of me like my mother. Is that undue pressure on the women we are marrying today?
Absolutely. I think it's undue pressure. But again, it goes back to what I said earlier on. That's what the man has seen.
Yeah.
You know, and you talked about, you know, what we take out from here.
Yeah.
I think the number one takeout is we need to create platforms where older men can mentor younger men.
Mm.
You see, we have made mistakes. And I am a believer that the wise person learns from the mistakes of others. The fool insists on making his own, you know? So we have made mistakes. We need to create a platform where people can talk with us and we can talk back with them. Unfortunately, the sad thing is that as people rise in society, you create this blockage, so there's no access. And like I said, people want to be heard. And when there is no access, then people get upset and people say stuff, you know, and people appear to be bitter, you know. So I think it's very important. I mean, Robert has I love what you do, and, you know, people on this panel, creating platforms, it starts on social media. When I created my resource page on Facebook, it was so that I could hear people, I could reach out to people. I think that's the most important thing we can leave this place with. So it's not just talk, like Pastor said, it's not just talk.
Mm-hmm.
Talk is cheap. There have been so many programs where people have talked, but nothing comes out of it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so let us resolve that after this, guys, reach out. Let us talk. And finally, one big mistake is a lot of times when we watch these success stories, and it applies in different areas, even in business, we watch these success stories, these people on social media and all that, and they make it look like they just appeared there, that everything is so good. And what that does is that when a younger person is starting the journey and they are having problems, they think there's something wrong with them, because we don't talk about our problems. We don't talk about our failures and our struggles. So I think that is so crucial. So anybody coming up, when he's facing that challenge, he will realize, oh wow, Trevor said he had gone through things like that, which is why I agree with some of the sentiments coming from social media that the true men's conference cannot be a public affair.
Okay.
Yeah.
Gala. Kijana ambaye anakusikiza leo, unataka ajifunze nini? Akitoka hapa ni nini akuwa melan?
Wajua kuna kitu ambacho kinasikitisha. Kuna mwambia ndugu yangu hapa. Wazee katika nyumba zetu tuna makosa ambayo tunayafanya. Mtoto wa kiume anakuja kukwambia dadi nina ABCD, unaambia akaongee na mamako. Na kuna wazee wengi sana wamefanya hivyo. Kwa hivyo inamaanisha mtoto wa kiume anakuzwa kike. Sababu ushauri anaoupata na maneno mengi anayoyapata ni kutoka kwa mama. Mama ni mzuri, lakini na wewe pia ukitamka atajua pia baba aliniambia hivi na anaweza kufuata. So sisi kama wanaume tuko hapa na wengine wanaosikiza, tujue lazima tufungue milango yetu kwa watoto wetu pia wa kiume. Tuache kuwasukuma sana kwa kina mama. Kwa sababu watapata ushauri mmoja, na wewe atakuangalia tabia zako ambazo umezificha, na labda uko nje hata ni mbaya zaidi. Kwa hivyo tubadilike katika malezi. Jambo lingine tujue, vile ambavyo tunakuza watoto wetu wa kike, ndio tunaonesha picha ya mwanamume ni mtu aina gani. Lakini huyu mume ambaye anakuja kukutana naye huku anakuwa ni mwanamume tofauti. Sasa wewe angalia vile ambavyo unamkuza mtoto wako wa kike, unampenda, ukija umemnunulia peremende, ukija umemnunulia nguo mpya, ukija umemfanyia kila kitu. Lakini uwe huyo mwanamume ambaye umefanya hivyo kwa mke wako ufanye. Na mwanamke yuko pale, ule mama mwenye nyumba yuko kuona. kwa sababu una mtoto wako msichana, kila ukija mama, huyo ndo wa kwanza umemuulizia, hata si mke wako. Kwa hivyo unamkuza sana mtoto wa kike kuliko huyu mama mwenyewe, na mama ata react kwa sababu mama ataka kupendwa. Kitu chengine nitasema ni binadamu alipoumbwa tuliambiwa mume alitolewa mbavu yake ndio ikaekwa kwa mwanamke. Sasa wewe jukumu lako kama mvulana ambaye mwanzo hujaoa ni kupata hii mbavu. Hii mbavu utaipata ukiwa fake. Ukienda ukikopa wewe uonekane katika hali ambazo si zako. Kisa na maana upate mwanamke. My friend, huyo mwanamke atakusumbua maisha yako yote kwa sababu wewe si real picture ya wewe. Wewe leo useme mimi kwa sababu nataka msichana kutoka msikitini, kwa hivyo nitaswali kwa mwaka mmoja yule msichana ajue mimi ni mtu wa kuswali sana ndio nimpate. My friend, wewe si mtu wa kuomba. Kwa hivyo ukishampata utawacha. Na huyu mwanamke ujue ulichukua hii property, ulichukua mbavu ya mtu mwenye kuswali. Na wewe si wa kuswali. So ita react, itataka kutoka hapa kwa sababu inahisi habilong hapo. Yeye alijua wewe ni mtu prayerful.
Yeah.
But mahusiano yote katika hii dunia yameanzishwa na Mungu mwenyewe. Mungu ndo alituumba. So hata tukajadiliana hapa vikao 50-100. Lakini tusiporudi kwa yule architect wa haya maisha.
Yeah.
Tunafeli.
Okay.
Yule ambaye alitengeneza haya maisha ni Mungu mwenyewe.
Yeah.
Kwa hivyo lazima turudi kwa Mungu, tujifikirie, tujifundishe kupitia kwa vitabu. Ile jamaa amesema siku hizi kuna wanahabari, kuna vipindi, vyote hati ndo tunavitumia kusoma. Kwa hivyo vyote vimebadilika na kila mtu ana akili yake katika hivi vitu. So vitu ambavyo havijabadilika ni vitabu vya dini.
Okay.
Kwa hivyo turudi katika vitabu vya dini.
Yeah.
Tusome, tuige mifano ya wale wanaume waliokuwa ndani ya vile vitabu.
Yeah.
Waliishi vipi, walifanya vipi. Na ndo itakuwa ni msingi bora wa kujifundisha maisha.
Okay.
Usijifundishe sana na mimi. Jifundishe sana na mifano ambayo imetumiwa katika uungu.
Alright.
Biblia, Quran na dini nyingine ambazo zipo.
Okay.
Alafu,
yeah, mwisho.
Tuombe Mungu sana. Mm. Usifikiria haya mambo utayafanya kwa nguvu zako. Hata mwanamke wako kama atakusumbua, hata kama mwanamume wako atakusumbua, sikudanganyi. Nenda kwa huyu Mungu ambaye alikuumba. Mwambie Mungu, hii product niliitafuta nikifikiria ni correct one.
Yeah.
Lakini sasa hivi ile inaenda nikaa inanishinda. Lakini sitaki nishinde, si nilichukua na nikaapa kwako ya kwamba hii kitu nitafanya nayo vizuri na nitakaa nayo kwa shida kwa raha. Sasa tafadhali, hapo mahali ambapo sipati huu ufafanuzi,
yeah,
na ufunuo, nipe.
Okay.
Huyu mrekebishe aingie pale ambao ningependa awe, tafadhali. Na wewe pia uwe umejieka katika hiyo line.
Asante sana. All right, so we've really run out of time, but I'd like to hear from the panelists in one line, what are the things people should implement? Just one line, but Kimani, I'm also coming back to you in just a bit to find out what the people think were ground, what are they going to implement from here? Pastor Kuria, tukianza na wewe, line moja tu, ni nini unataka mwanaume implement leo?
Ile kitu nataka mwanaume implement ni kwamba,
yes,
ajue yeye si mwanamke.
Bas, hivyo. Burale, in one line.
Just understand you are here for a purpose. Find out your purpose, dominate and succeed.
Brilliant. Asmali.
Be yourself. Remember the word compromise and be your brother's keeper.
Fantastic. Mkala.
Biblia imesema mpende mkeo na mkeo akuheshimu. Wanaume tuna mbegu ya kupenda.
Bas.
Tupende kikweli.
Brilliant. Wale.
Be true to yourself. Behind all the facade of social media,
yeah,
and the, you know, mob, everybody being together, when you are hurting, you will, yeah, be alone. Never forget that.
All right. Kimani, go ground. What are they implementing?
Well. Before we go there, to go ground. Yeah. Rory Media Services, in conjunction with our very, very fantastic digital product, Visasa. We're giving you guys today one for the boys. It's happening at the Carnival tonight from 7 p.m. You want to go there. Music will be by Roy T-Boy and other fantastic DJs from Hot 96. All the radio presenters will be there. Go there at the Carnival from 7 p.m. One for the boys. If you guys and your boys don't have any plans, because all the single boys out there, I ain't single, but I ain't going for this one. Single, but I'll still be there. It's called One for the Boys at the Carnival tonight. Let's meet there. Now, let's see who is... okay, so raise your hand if you want to speak. How many do I have?
Oh, wow. We've really run out of
all
time.
All of them. We've so really run out of time.
One from each table, really.
One
fast.
From each table, okay?
Yeah.
Real quick. Gentlemen, you have 30 seconds. If you go for more than 30 seconds, I move on. Let's start with that table very fast.
They've chosen the guy over there, yes.
Okay, you guys, we're out of time? Okay.
One
Real
line.
Quick, 30 seconds. 30
One
seconds.
Line.
What we're implementing, my name is Elvis. You can call me, I'm Kuria. We are not buying flowers today.
Okay.
We are not buying
that.
Flowers today.
One line like
Kuria,
that.
Amekata. One line, gentlemen.
My name is Michael Mbongai. What we are implementing here is that there can never be equality between men and women.
That's
men
it.
Are the image of God. Women are the exact opposite of men, the lower
it.
Beings.
One line,
gentlemen.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm Joseph Jonge. Now, men's conference was to console men and also give them advice. I've not had anyone thanking the good men out there.
Okay.
So congratulations and thank you for the men who are doing the good job and the love. Yes.
Brilliant. One line.
Thank
one
you.
Line.
One line. One line.
One line.
Yes, we'll be here.
Over
one
here.
Line. Oh, let's give the old man to say something.
My name is Ezekiel Libamira. We have talked about asking the man to be a man.
Yeah.
But before we do that, let's define who is that man.
Okay. Brilliant.
Thank you.
One,
that's
one
fine.
Last line,
line
over
one
there.
Line. One line. Gentlemen.
I'm Elliot Bett. Man enough is providing a leadership provider good service.
It has to be
thank
one
you.
Line. All right.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, it depends on how
one
you spend
last
your line.
Gentleman over here. And then
the
I'm
last line. That's the last line.
My name is Joshua Tamach. On the sixth day, God created man. And man must dominate. Thank you.
All right. Brilliant.
Man must dominate.
That's
wow.
What we
I like that.
Now.
Guys, back to you, Trevor.
Well, thanks, Kimani. Remember, there's a lot that we are leaving our man's house, you know. It's our friend, Sarova Stanley, here. But there's still a lot happening around here, so you can come by. The Cupid's Affair is here, 6,500. Pool Deck Restaurant, Fortune Cookie Surprise, candy bars for the couples, a rose flower for all the ladies, complimentary glass of wine. If you want to extend that and make it a night or two, it's 21,000 per couple per night. It's called Reigniting the Passion, the Weekend of Love. Dinner for two with a bottle of wine, bedside breakfast, fruit basket in the room, 30 minutes head and shoulder massage. Make your way to the Stanley, smack in the middle of the CBD. That's where we are. This has been the men's conference. Thank you so much to my panelists, and thank you so much for everyone who appeared. This cannot be a conversation alienating one side. Even though we're talking about men's conference, the women will always be there as well. I'm sure most of you out there, if I asked you who's your number one woman in your life, you talk about your mother. So the women will always be part of us, all right? That's where we leave it for now. My name is Trevor Mbija. Always a pleasure having you with us, and give it up for Roy T-Boy. He's the one on the desk this morning. And happy Valentine's.